Shall we begin? First off, let me express my appreciation to everyone seated at this table. Given recent events, it's encouraging to know that we can still rise above our differences in the spirit of mutual...
I want to talk about Mosiah.
Gain. What about him?
He's dead. And before we rise above anything, I want to hear your cowardly fuck of a captain apologize for it.
I'd like a moment to confer with my colleague. Outside.
That was my fault. Entirely my fault. I should have been clearer when I prepared you for this meeting. When I said we would need to keep our tempers in check if we were going to make this meeting happen, I should have specified we'd need to do so for the duration of the meeting as well.
Not to worry. Simple setback.
Now we have clarity and a unity of vision. I feel good. You?
All righty then.
What Captain Flint meant to say is that we have a crew to answer to. And whether we can reach an agreement around this table is meaningless if we can't sell it to our men. Having lost a valued and respected brother, they will want to know what's been done about it.
Without accepting responsibility for your loss, I can see a small allowance being made for goodwill.
How much did you have in mind?
£10,000. That's from Mosiah. Now let's talk about his man that you killed.
No, that's all right. We can wait.
Well, at this rate, the Urca will get to Cadiz and back again before we resolve anything. I'm going to take a piss.
Be honest. Are you as surprised as I am? And I'm the only one here behaving myself.
Share per man. Two for the captain, two additional for use of the ship, and five set aside in a fund to offset injury payments.
Share half for the captain, one for the ship. Injuries come out of your end.
But your men get priority on unique items.
Ooh. Done. Oh, just one more thing.
Don't push your luck, Jack.
No, the terms are agreeable. My concern is who will enforce them.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Your role in propping up Captain Flint was made clear when you assaulted my captain the other night. What's to stop you from altering the terms of the deal after the fact to see it suit a more favored party? I'd feel much better if our deal had a more impartial guarantor.
And who did you have in mind?
The only person around here that isn't beholden to Ms. Guthrie for their livelihood. Her father.
Are you fucking kidding me? What have we been doing here all day? If you're planning on pulling this shit...
Certainly he can be persuaded to come down off the mountain, as it were, bless our little arrangement. Unless I'm missing something.
My father doesn't know about this.
I see.
But you have my word. His terms should be honoured.
Perhaps it would be wise to revisit our terms to account for this added risk.
No one's revisiting shit. We had a fucking deal.
I've
heard enough.
The terms are fine. Her word's good enough for me. And it's good enough for you, too. Well, can we consider this a deal?